This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is our sixth example of solving a basic equation containing fractions. All right, so what do we do here? Well, we've got 5/8 x, which means 5/8 times x equals 12. So what would you do? To isolate the x, you have something times x, you can multiply by the reciprocal. So the reciprocal of 5/8 is 8/5. By the way, dividing by 5/8 is the same thing as multiplying by 8/5. So some people learn it this way. They go dividing by 5/8 to both sides and canceling that. But as you see, it makes kind of a complicated looking fraction over here. So that's why it's easier to multiply by the reciprocal. Okay, so what happens? Well, the 5s and the 8s cancel, so I'm going to find out what x equals right here. And we see if anything cancels over here. So this is the first of our problems where nothing canceled. That's fine. You could think of that as 12 over 1. So our answer is, we'll multiply the numerators, 12 times 8, which is, let's see, I think that's 120. No, it's not. It's 96. Right, okay, so it's 96 over 5. All right, now it's perfectly fine to leave an answer like that. You could write that as a mixed number, but it is reduced. So if you're not told that you have to write it as a mixed number, it's fine to leave it like this. You could also write it as a decimal by dividing 96 divided by 5. Generally, when solving equations, and they're not word problems, I usually just leave them reduced fractions. Don't worry about changing them to mixed numbers. Okay, now another way of doing the same problem is getting rid of the denominator first by multiplying both sides by the least common denominator. So this is the alternate method that some people prefer. Multiply both sides by 8 first so that those 8s cancel. Then we have 5x equals 96. That's 12 times 8. And then you could divide both sides by 5. So hopefully you're seeing what's going on here. Here, I'm multiplying by 8 to get 5x equals 96, and then I'm dividing by 5. When you multiply by 8/5, you're really doing that at the same time. You're multiplying by 8, dividing by 5. That's what it means to multiply by 8/5. So you're doing it all in one step. So this is just an option. It's not like one way is necessarily better than another, because some people find one way easier than the other way. That's perfectly fine. As long as we get our answer and we check it, we're okay. So x equals 96/5. Let's check it. All right, so we take our original problem, 5/8 times 96/5. So we're going to plug in 96/5. And let's see, the 5s cancel. And we get 96/8. Okay, now you could either do long division and do 96 divided by 8, and you're going to get 12, or you could just start reducing it. Like, I sort of noticed that I could reduce dividing the top and bottom by 2, that's 48/4, and that's easier for me to do the division in my head. 48 divided by 4 is 12. It doesn't really matter how you reduce that, but eventually 96 over 8 is going to end up being 12. And on the right side, we also have 12. So it's correct, which means our solution up here is correct. So that means the answer is indeed x equals 96/5 is the correct solution. And if we were going to write it in set notation, we'd have 96/5 in the braces. That's the solution set. In other words, that's the number that makes that equation true. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.